one of the most anticipated consoles. I'm talking about Sony's PlayStation 4, and I'm lucky to have my hands on one before it even launches here in Europe. And so far, experts are impressed.
I think having spent the morning playing with the PlayStation 4, it turns out it's a very good console, and it's a very solid console. You've then got the remote play stuff, which makes it really interesting. We were playing Shadowfall on a PS Vita. Admittedly, it was in the same room, but you wouldn't have to be in the same room. Initially, when we started playing, the original PlayStation was somewhere else. And that will appeal to people that have to share their television or just want to go and play in the bedroom.
The rival Microsoft is launching the Xbox One. So what does this mean for Sony?
I think Microsoft are very much playing that they want this to be the console of the living room, and console not necessarily meaning games, but more about sort of home entertainment, about videos, you know, about it, a lot more than just games. But the focus from what I've seen with the PlayStation 4 this morning is that it seems to be very much about, here's some brilliant games, you know, whether it's Killzone, Shadowfall, or Hokum, or Flower, or things like this. You know, it seems to be, this is for gamers, and we're very unabashedly going to say that that's the case.
So a lot of noise around the console, and when it comes to investing in Sony, Saxo Bank's Peter Garnry says it's game on.
It was a little bit of a surprise where they priced the PS4. It is priced at $399 compared to the Xbox, which is priced $100 higher. So that was the first initial surprise, and that's okay because it means that they can penetrate and sell more volume, and it also indicates that they're more confident about the cost levels on the PS4. They have struggling with their margins and their profitability, but it seems like it has turned around the last year, and actually it has outperformed Japanese stocks in general. It's up 85%, so although I'm not very keen on Sony in the long term, I think they have an interesting pipeline. I think I will give them the benefit of the doubt and actually be quite positive from here on as an investment over the next year.
It's a hard battle to the top of the gaming industry, but for now it seems like Sony's playing the right kind of game.